They're real fresh.
Just a minute. Keep one with you. The carrot? Oh, I want to kiss it.
Sorry, old pal.
Three.
Yeah, 3,000 seems like a fair price to me.
3,000 for that plug? 300.
Is he missing a leg or something?
$300.
Come on,
He's a great horse. You're embarrassing him.
Final offer. $300.
Sorry, Joe.
This is our last carrot. At least you'll be eating every day.
Took you so long, huh? Leaving it up on the stud farm?
Oh, here's number three.
Thanks.
Well, you really pack it away.
I like good food.
Just good food?
Good company. How about dinner?
You already had yours.
All right.
Is there a motel nearby?
Try Maude's. First house on the right as you enter town. Big bed. Working man's breakfast. And it won't set you back much, neither.
Maude's, you said?
Hey, Maude! Shake your leg!
Hold your horses!
Is that your circus wagon out there? You're Renegade Luke, ain't you?
Pleased to meet you.
I wouldn't be so sure. Are you the right guy or ain't you? No. If you were, a certain friend wants to see you.
What friend?
Could be a guy called Moose. Does that ring a bell?
All right, what's the story with Moose? So?
He's rotten in the state prison and wants to see you. He says you're the only guy he trusts. If you ask me, he's nuts.
You wait here.
Keep the change.
Thanks. Are you out of the door? Sure.
Rich man's door. Sorry, Ma. Just gotta go.
Well, if ever, you know the address.
Hey.
place to have a renegade squad reunion.
Yeah, what made you change your address?
Well, they call it vehicular homicide. He's running some guy down on purpose.
I don't buy it.
Hell, look, I could have done what you want the jury. They set me up for some big shot.
Give me the names.
Forget about it. I brought you here because I want to talk to you about another problem I have.
What is it?
Well, it's a long story. Fact is, I have a son.
Hey, great. How old is he?
14, going on 25. You know the kind. Tough kid.
Just like his dad.
To think I had plans, can you imagine? Me worried about the future. So help me if it ain't true. I even own some land.
Yeah, I can't believe it.
Okay, I want it in a poker game. What the hell's the difference? I got the dates and everything. I got it all here. It's a beautiful place, Luke. It's called Greenhaven.
Greenhaven.
It's a valley up in northern Arizona. It's got a house right on the lake, like a picture postcard.
So what do you want me for?
I put the land in the kid's name. But he's only 14. Contract ain't legal for a couple of years.
So?
So, I signed his custody over to you.
Can I be kidding?
It's all there on the last page. Which makes you his legal guardian until he's 16.
No way. I ain't gonna sign that.
You don't have to. My cellmate's the best forger in the state.
I can't have a kid tagging along with me.
Child abandonment is a very serious offense, Luke. Besides, he's a great kid. Well, any.
How would I know? Oh, no. Not him. That obnoxious
wise, my boy. Oh, he's a little shit kicker, but you'll see. On the trip, he'll start growing on you.
Like athlete's foot. What trip?
Greenhaven. You ain't been listening to me. I want you to settle down there. Keep an eye on the kid.
Sorry, Moose. What you need is a nice guy.
What I need is a good, solid, decent, upright son of a bitch. You don't have to do nothing you don't want to do. Thanks anyway. No hard feelings.
No hard feelings.
You're no good son of a...
Okay.
I love you, Luke.
Talking to me?
Get your feet down and clean up the mess.
Now, you listen to me, Hotshot. The only reason you're still in one piece is because you're related to a friend of mine. But I'm warning you, don't play smartass with me. Get the picture?
Now you listen to me, Buckshot. The only reason I'm in this horseshit factory is because Moose wants it that way. But there ain't no one who's gonna tell me what to do.
It's obvious you take me for some kind of an idiot.
I don't know you that well. Not yet.
You will, kid. You will.
Hey, all right. Old Red Eye.
That's whiskey.
weird, you and Moose being friends. I mean, I didn't know he hung around with wimps. Well, at least you got a nice horse. What's his name?
Joe Brown.
Joe Brown.
Stopping for?
Well, that they're fun, now it's our turn. I can't see him from here. Are they getting out?
No. Yeah. Now they're getting out.
They look around. They spot us.
Yeah, right.
They're coming after us. Not running, but moving fast.
They don't look very happy. Are you sure this is a good idea?
No sweat. They're starting to jog now.
Yeah, right. If these guys look really pissed off...
The madder, the better.
They're getting close.
I see them now.
What the hell are you waiting for?
No sweat. Come on, boys. Charge!
They're gonna get us.
Not if we move, they won't.
The faster they go, the faster we go. The faster we go, the faster they go.
They're slowing down.
Then we slow down.
Stop.
Then we stop.
They're dead. They're crapping out. They're gonna croak.
Gosh! Anger can work miracles if you know what buttons to push. Watch this.
This is another one of your jokes, right? Right?
Aren't you interested in any other sports?
Yeah, sharpshooting.
Yeah, with your big mouth.
I can bullseye anything.
You?
Watch this.
Good shot.
Oh, she needs some help.
Get back here. One more time.
They got help.
Hey, don't turn around.
What's the matter?
The truckers.
Plan.
I don't think they recognize me, but they got a good look at you. So, get down and tie your shoes.
Hey! Who owns a deadbeat horse out there?
Which? The one in the trailer?
Yeah.
Hooked up to a Jeep?
Yeah.
A guy in the kit?
Yeah.
You broke your windshield with a beer bottle?
Yeah, yeah.
I made you run like...
Yeah, yeah.
Well then, you must be lucky for me.
Good going.
Just lucky. Keep the change.
You do dollar show.
Oh.
Never mind. On the house.
Thanks. One more,
them to do meow.
Here had a TV on full blast. He just loves that Miami Vice.
Hey man, what's with you?
What do you mean?
That guy in the window meant business. He wasn't playing any game.
Sure turned it into one, didn't we?
You always even your scores like that?
Why not? As long as I have a choice.
Why? What was I supposed to do? Go for their throats?
Don't you want any respect?
I don't need that kind of respect.
You must be some kind of a jinx. I've only been with you 2 days and already had 4 close calls.
Huh. I was just thinking the same thing. So what do you want?
3 cheeseburgers, a hamburger, hey, large fries.
Take it easy.
What's the matter?
This is all that stands between us and starvation. 2 burgers and 2 Cokes, please.
395,
drive up. Get ready, Joe.
Forget that. There's no suckers for your horse trick in this town.
How do you know about that?
Booze.
Who else? So what do you want to do? Rob an old lady?
Nope. Card pegging.
Card pegging? What's that?
I let a guy pick a card, shuffle the card in the deck, throw the deck in the air, spear his card against the wall.
Terrific. Then to figure out the trick and turn us into dog food.
No way.
Why not?
There is no trick.
Oh, sure. No trick.
Thank you.
Listen, if you're too chicken, you can wait outside. How about a game, mister?
Sure, why not?
Hey, what the hell do you think you're doing?
I'm sorry, I'm not too good with these.
That hurt damn sure. You almost stuck my head.
I'm sorry. If using a knife would be a different story, but with these materials.
Oh, yeah? What can you do with a knife?
You name it. I can bullseye a playing card in midair.
That's the biggest line of bull I've heard in years, kid. And I mean it.
You could even hide the card in a full deck.
Wait a minute.
You mean to say that if I throw a deck of cards into the air, you can catch one with a knife?
Not just anyone. It's one of your choice.
In a deck of 52 cards?
Sure. Want to bet?
You hear this, hotshot? You got some mouth, kid.
According to you, I got a 1 in 52 chance of hitting your card, right?
According to me, you're lucky if you hit the wall.
All right. I'll bet you one of my bucks against 52 of yours that I pegged the card of your choice.
All right, you're on. This'll teach you not to rag.
I'll bet you all I got. $10.
But I haven't got $520.
You don't know how lucky you are, mister.
You got a pretty big mouth, kid. My daddy would have locked me in a woodshed if you heard me talking like that.
Yeah. All these kids nowadays. Bunch of smart alecks.
Maybe. But money talks. Bullshit walks.
Listen.
Why don't we give this punk a lesson?
Let's give him a whiff of $520. And then have a round of beer on his table. Okay?
Here's my five.
Got more?
Yeah.
That's great, thanks.
Hey, yeah, we'll give them this.
All right.
Yeah, sure. Hey, Saturday night.
Yeah?
All right. More here.
Hey, let me borrow your hat. Great. Here. More? More here. We got some more. Hey, we're having fun tonight, okay? Hey, it's great. What a good beer. All right. $520 against your 10.
Here you go.
Hold that, will you? I need a deck of cards.
You missed it.
Oh, great. What card do you want?
I already told you. The card of your choice.
Jack of diamonds, okay?
Perfect.
Jack of diamonds.
Yeah.
All right. Jack of diamonds.
The one that you can now, don't hold him back.
Ready when you are.
Drought's over. Here comes the beer.
Come on already. Hurry up.
Yeah.
Jack of diamonds.
My knife.
You throw a mean knife, kid.
Can someone give me a ride? I said, can someone give me a ride?
Oh, I'm heading north.
So am I. Thanks. Come on, let's get out of here, Luke.
Well, it was real smart of you to call me by name. Look, if you're still in one piece.
Here. Just a minute. Ooh.
Seen so many all at once. I wonder which one's our lucky star.
They're all lucky. Take your pick.
Look at the shine on that one over there.
Wow.
I hope it's Moose's lucky star, too. So bad when she gets to know them.
Says who?
How do you like that? Sweet butt.
Yeah.
Lar doesn't move his butt. I'll have to do it for him.
I wouldn't do that.
Oh, no? What do the laws of the jungle call for in this case?
Forgetting we got Joe Brown in the back. They'd be on us in a second.
Right. Listen, Rodap, what do you say we handle this, just you and me?
What'd you call me?
I call you Rodap, but if you want, I can call you by your name. Bag of shit.
I'm gonna take my teeth if you wish, Paul.
You're not going to have anything.
Call me a road apple. My name is Chickadee.
Like a birdie?
Yeah.
You okay, Luke?
Yeah.
Carve my initials in your face.
Be my guest.
Hey, wait a minute, aren't you? Yeah. Matt the Stitcher. Rico! Cool Blade Rico!
Oh, Rico.
Hey, man, what's happening?
How you doing?
Hey, Rico, what the hell is going on here, man?
Matt the Stitcher. He saved my brother Nick's ass when he got in trouble with the Tigers.
What you doing?
Nothing much. Bunch of us heading to Phoenix, Arizona desert run. 50 kegger. Chicks. Music. Real blowout. How about you?
I'm checking out a piece of land my old man won at poker. He's busy right now.
Who's he?
A friend I'm taking along with me. Not bad, huh?
Not at all.
Who's the animal?
Bad for the Chickadee. Hey, Chickadee! He's Matt, the Stitcher. Nick's friend, remember? Time the Tigers are gonna slice him up?
Yeah. Who's the mad dog here?
It's a friend of his.
You gave some bad company, man. What do you say we get to the bottom of this? Huh, a little piece of goodwill? All right.
Does this happen often, or are we special?
Oh, you're special. You're special. Guy laid $1,000 on us to flatten you.
What?
Who was he?
I don't know, man. Plumbed himself off as a lawyer. Did that ring any bells?
Not really, but thanks for the tip.
Sure thing. Next time you guys are down in Phoenix, stop by the stadium and we're having a run.
Just bring yourselves. We got the chicks and the beer.
Sounds great.
Stitcher, thanks for Nicky.
No problem. Drown, Rico. Yeah. Guys, huh?
Yeah, once you get to know him. Well, let's get moving.
Jack. How much longer till Greenhaven?
Well, if you drive straight through, we'll make it by dawn. Think you can handle it?
Anything you can do,
I can do better. Anybody here?
Deliver up yourself and bring me the cash.
I don't need gas. I just need information.
Then just bring me the cash.
I'm looking for the Greenhaven Valley turnoff. Sign back south at 2 miles, but I must have missed it. Well?
Well, what?
Greenhaven Valley.
Why would you be going there?
I asked you for an answer, not a question.
Well, my answer is, I don't know.
And if Pedro for an I don't know?
If he says he don't know, he don't know.
Why don't you mind your own damn...
Sorry, officer.
Sheriff.
Sorry, Sheriff. I just took you for some kind of idiot. I mean, you know what I mean.
Yeah, I think I know what you mean. Is that your Jeep?
Yes, sir.
You know, you come and ask for the Greenhaven turnoff.
Well, what do you know?
Just, where's a Greenhaven turnoff? Just like that, he said.
Well, it takes all kinds. You mind if I inspect your Jeep?
Yes, bud. Go ahead.
You stay put. Put your hands up on the truck.
Hey.
Spread your legs
wide. There, he your boy?
No, it's my brother Matt.
What pet the horse?
Name's Joe Brown.
And you're going to Greenhaven.
Why, is that bad?
You bet it is.
You gonna be here for a while?
Yes, love. I mean, officer.
You beat it. But you remember one thing, horse. We don't like troublemakers here.
Gotcha. What about the turn?
Quarter mile down the road. On your right.
Thanks. Much obliged.
Lawson Enterprises, Mr. Lawson, please. This Sheriff Martin. They're here, sir.
Hey, isn't that a house back there?
That's it.
Well, now what do you say?
Nice size room.
Hey, look. We already got mail.
Let me see. Well, all it needs is a little elbow grease. That's all.
Where's the TV?
Huh?
Why isn't there any TV?
Because there's no electricity.
No football. No wrestling. This place is the pits.
Hey, listen to this. Lawson Enterprises. We'd like to arrange an appointment to discuss the terms of a proposed offer and so on and so on. Well, let's get to it.
Hey! You there, in the house.
What's that?
I am Eli, and I'm coming in peace.
Oh, that's a welcome change.
Come on in.
We're neighbors.
Oh. One of the brothers chopping wood. Saw you arrive. So I've come to bring you the greetings of the valley.
Oh, thanks. My name is Luke. Luke Mantee. And this is Matt.
May the good Lord protect you, Matt.
Thanks. Freddy got him on my back.
The voice of innocence.
I wouldn't bet on it.
Ah, of all God's creatures, there's none so unbridled as a young lad, said a prophet.
You're telling me.
I'd be honored if you'd come and meet my family and partake of some supper.
Food?
Oh, thanks, but we still have to
Don't worry about that. That'll take care of itself.
Well?
Just you wait and see. Ah, there's nothing like a bowl of soup and a steaming plate of stew to change your outlook in life.
Yeah, I could really pick out in some stew.
He means he'd be honored to partake.
Oh, yeah. Wonderful. Wonderful.
You know, Luke, a lot of faiths in our country claim to have the good Lord on their side. Well, we're happy if he lets us side with him.
Hey, whoa, boy. Whoa. Hey. Tallulah! Tallulah! A melody! Come on.
They're my daughters. They're my daughters, yeah? My pride and joys. This gentleman is Mr. Luke Mantee.
Pleased to meet you.
And this here is Matt.
Hi, Matt. You like it here?
Yeah.
Just wait and see.
How ready, Luke?
Soon, Ma.
This young man is hungry.
How'd you guess?
Come with me, Matt. I've got muffins in the oven, and I can't tell if they're done yet.
I'll test them for you.
Whoa! Ah, here they are!
My prime joys.
What about the others?
Still at work. It's gonna take a while.
I'll be heading back for them.
Oh, thanks, Martin. Thanks. It's lunchtime, Martin. Thanks.
He and Batula, they're gonna get married. Martin and Batula.
Oh.
Oh, you're gonna see chopping wood. Fantastic. Sprout.
Martin, thanks. Deal time, Martin.
Look what's happening.
Oh, Tallulah made that.
She cooks too? Huh? Oh, it smells good.
Oh, yeah.
Why don't you give thanks for the meal?
Sure. Thanks a lot for lunch.
No, she meant to the Lord.
Oh.
You see, look, it's our tradition. The guest has the honor of saying grace.
Huh? Oh, much obliged. Well, then. Dear Lord, it's been quite a while. Maybe you don't remember me, but all the same, I'd like to thank you for letting us meet with these beautiful people and for this... good, wonderful, juicy stew. We'll keep in touch.
Amen. Amen. Let's say, son, you have a way with the Lord, son.
Yeah, we get along all right.
Thank you.
Boy, talk about friendly neighbors.
Yeah. Reminds me of when me and Moose went to the Bronx. The very first night someone ripped off our front door while we were sleeping.
Hey, and that was some supper.
Yeah. Those chicks. Can you believe the bounty?
Hey, that's blasphemy. You know, I better have a man-to-man talk about the opposite sex.
Sure. What do you want to know?
Hey.
What's the matter?
The house. There's a light in there. I don't believe it.
It's like Mary Poppins come true.
Hey. Look at this.
Apples, bread, jelly, and eggs.
First few days, then?
Oh, no.
You don't like Mary Poppins anymore?
Sure. If it means giving a hand to the farmer's daughters, why not?
Gee, you're sick.
Oh, don't jive me. I saw you playing footsie with what's her name? Tallulah.
Oh, go to bed.
Yeah, Rice, change the subject.
I'm Ross, Anthony Ross. Hello.
Oh.
And this is my partner, Ed Ryan.
Lawyers?
Yes, how do you do, sir?
Hi. We represent Lawson Incorporated, and we have a business opportunity for you, which I'm sure you won't be able to refuse.
We'll just steal a minute of your time.
You don't have to steal.
Thank you, sir.
Hey, Luke. I'll keep an eye on the Blues Brothers.
Check. Note. Last but not least, the contract.
First of all, I'm glad to see that you're not one of those weirdo fanatics. You like your neighbors.
Fanatics?
Very strange people. If I were you, I'd stay away.
Yeah.
Like all bigots, they can be trouble.
In a nutshell, Mr. Mantee, Lawson Enterprises wants to buy up all of Greenhaven Valley.
Ah.
For your tiny spread, he's willing to offer, say...
Say, I'm not interested. Thank you, bud. What did you say?
Land's not for sale.
If you're holding out for a better offer, forget it. There won't be a better offer. Many people.
Hey.
What's
calling up? Looks like rain.
You're stepping in high water, friend. Over your head. I wouldn't cross, Mr. Lawson.
Take the advice. Free of charge.
Take mine. Beat it.
Here they come!
Want to go out?
Here comes another one.
Come on, who's next?
Now wait, stop. That's enough.
You know where the door is.
The helicopter!
Listen, if you cut through the woods, it'll be just 20 miles to town. Why don't you have a nice walk? There, this is yours.
Boom!
Yours. Have a nice day. Watch out for the grizzlies. Hey, Moose taught you all the tricks, didn't he?
Yeah, he said he learned that one from you.
Huh, well... it works even better if you wrap the throttle with masking tape.
Didn't Chickadee mention lawyers?
Yeah, he did.
I guess they're hoping by putting the pressure on us, we'd back off. And this time, Moose would sell. Those bastards.
Well, we won the first round, didn't we?
Hey, I was figuring on making a little music with Melody. I'm taking the girls into town shopping. If you got nothing better to do, I could ask her to bring her sister.
All right.
I'd like 4 yards of white cotton, please.
I'm sorry, Miss Tallulah, but I'm plumb out.
But, Mr. Mulligan, there are several bolts right over there.
I told you, it's sold.
Matt, why don't you take the girls for an ice cream?
On the hood and you make it snappy.
Me too, Sheriff.
You shut your mouth. You're in big trouble, Miss Tanfriend. What do you want? You were doing 70.
So what?
So what? Can't you read the road signs?
I wasn't driving on the road. So 70's legal.
You don't go telling me what's legal. I'm the law in this county.
Out having a little fun, huh?
Mind, we don't like troublemakers in these parts.
Sounds familiar to me.
And don't you forget it. Get your ass out there on that road where it's legal, and you make it at 55 miles out, or you're going to be my guest tonight.
Yes, officer.
Sheriff! Get!
I want to leave him a forget-me-not. Keep a steady speed.
No way.
5, 4, 3. Hey, all right. Right in the cahungas.
Cahungas? What are they?
Your
daughter's back, safe
and sound. Great job, Patrol.
Look at all that fabric.
Thanks to Lulu and...
It's a clearance sale.
That's just red.
Give my best to Eli.
Seeing
you. Thanks again.
You're welcome. You bet.
Bye now.
You know something, brother? I'm beginning to like this place. It's certainly growing on me.
It's got a fracture.
Definitely.
What's the matter with Joe Brown?
Just taking a nap, as usual.
Come on, get up, you bum. I said, get up.
Maybe there's something wrong.
Oh, nah, you don't know him. He's the laziest horse on earth.
Come on. Hey, Joe Brown, what's happening? Calm down.
Maybe he's trying to tell us something.
What's the matter with him?
So, I guess they made a change on the real estate deal.
Now, what's Moose gonna say?
What happened?
Looks like a message from Mr. Lawson. I guess he couldn't find a mailbox, so he left it by the door.
Why, he could have killed you. Good Lord, maybe he intended to.
They're very determined, Luke. Have you got the strength to fight on? Or shall we give up?
I don't think so.
Yeah.
Mr. Lawson.
Your name, please?
Luke Mantee.
This way, sir.
Mr. Lawson?
Worst thing you could have done was come in here, Luke.
You?
Me.
He's on 46 headed out of town.
I tell the sheriff to keep out of this. Okay, let's go.
I have a right to know what I'm dying for.
Lawson isn't Lawson.
My life depends on that?
It's a long story. He's the one who set up Moose.
So he could rip off his land?
No, because he didn't want to be recognized.
How would you know?
Because I recognized him.
You know Lawson, too?
Yeah, right.
If Lawson isn't Lawson, then who the hell is he?
Jeez, man, can't we talk about this later?
You mean after I'm dead?
Down there.
You gotta call the cops. Get ready to jump.
Thank you.
Once a fighter, always a fighter, huh, Lou? You realize I gotta get rid of you. You can put yourself in my shoes.
The shoes of a captain who betrays his platoon. Your shoes are too tight for me.
Now, we were carrying 500,000 vials of morphine. It's a matter of priority. My future comes out on top. You and Moose had me fooled. I thought you were dead.
I thought the same about you.
I saw you with my own eyes, floating down the river, your face down.
Yeah, I was hurt. Moose dove in, dragged me to shore, saved my life.
He saved his own skin in the process. That's when everything went wrong. I shouldn't have taken your death for granted. Otherwise, you must admit, I pulled this thing off rather neatly. Pure morphine, your mark for the camp hospital. An enemy ambush to account for the casualties. My dog tag in flames. And tears for the fallen heroes.
Then fallen hero Lenny Kovacs takes his blood money and becomes a respected businessman, Andrew Lawson.
Well, you see why I have to get rid of you.
Well, sort of.
You never would have let Moose rot in prison, and I would have been up the proverbial creek without paddling.
I could argue with that.
See?
Wait a minute. How do my neighbors fit into all this?
I'm going to buy them out for my development project. Strictly business. And after all, I am a respectable businessman. If it hadn't been
for Moose winning a piece of that land at poker.
Poker?
Yeah, poker.
You gotta understand, Luke, I can't have Moose hanging around. I called in some favors, put some pressure on. Nothing personal, you understand. Just routine business.
Yeah, but Moose wouldn't sell.
Exactly. So I had it organized so he'd have a permanent stay in a government rest home. Pretty good figure, huh?
Yeah, till I showed up.
Yeah. Yeah, you were the bad news, Luke. You were the bad news.
You said.
Thank you.
Weren't you supposed to call the police?
These guys were quicker.
Yeah.
He's the skunk?
Yeah.
Letting me go was worth $100,000 to you. $200,000. $300,000.
Shh. How sweet it is.
Joe Brown. You know where they are? You know where they are? Yes? You gonna take me to them?
All right, all right.
Hey, Luke.
Come on, Gerald Brown.
Trouble starting this rig.
It starts when I wanted to.
Where are we going now?
To pick up Moose.
Right now? How long is it gonna take?
2 days. If nothing gets in our way.
Hey, Mac.
What?
The truck.
The money, huh?
Nothing doing. It must be the fuel pump.
No way, not this time.
It's not the fuel pump. We're out of gas.
Hi! Nice day, huh? I mean it. Come check it out.
He's just playing possum. That's what he wants you to do, you dumb shit.
Hey, feel like a beer? Got plenty in the cooler.
Why don't you just go ahead and make them sandwiches while you're at it?
Maybe he really is out of gas.
All of a sudden, just like that. God, yes.
Maybe he really is out of gas. See? What'd I tell you?
You're coming, Luke. They're not playing around, Luke. They got crowbars this time.
Yeah.
Come on.
All right.
Bye.